in capes.
And now to our sneaky.
Thank you for tuning in with Chris and Roger.
Dude, those are awesome socks.
Thank you.
As we entertain the geeky.
Guys, what's going on?
What's up, Chris?
Roger, how are you?
I'm fantastic. How are you?
Good. New year.
New year, new fro, new do, new job, new life, new company, new everything.
New cupcakes.
Cupcakes?
There's no cupcakes.
I want cupcakes now.
So, guys, what's going on? Super excited to be entertaining you geekies.
Trying to. Dude, so I finally watched Logan.
Okay, so Logan came out last March.
Yeah, I'm a little behind the times on that. It was kind of my boycott phase.
Roger looks for, you literally, you look for things to say no about and to be pissed off about.
I was never pissed about Logan. Like, you go back and listen to the episodes, like, I haven't seen it, blah, blah, blah. I'm pissed off about superhero movies. I think they just need to stop.
Oh, shut up.
But I'm not mad about Logan. I was never mad about Logan. But I have a thought. I have a thought.
Are we going to talk about the death scene?
No. We'll get to that in a minute.
Okay.
Because, you know, you got to throw out spoiler alert for the people that haven't seen it yet.
If you guys haven't seen Logan at this point, go fucking watch it now.
But my thought, and I called you right after I watched Logan.
Yes, you did.
And I was like, hey.
Oh, okay.
Hey. So we hear that the X-Men died. And,
yep.
And we assume, we thought it was Wolverine, you know, blah, blah, blah. When you're like, oh, okay, Wolverine killed the X-Men. Because that's kind of what happened in the comics.
Mm-hmm.
But then we find out there was a Winchester incident. And it's dealing with Professor X.
Yep.
And then right before Professor X dies, he leans over and he's like, you know, I know what I did. You try to let me forget, but I know what I did. You also hear, after the stroke he had in the casino, over the radio, very softly.
Seizure.
Yeah, Caesar. Very softly, it was like the Winchester incident of a year ago. So my thought was, is it possible that Onslaught was released? Like, that was...
that? Yeah, he called me and he's like, Chris, do you think it was Onslaught? And I was like, what? No. Support yourself. Because I wanted to hear his theory behind it.
So my thought is this. The seizures, right?
Mm-hmm.
He's the strongest telepath the world has ever known. If his mind goes blank and da-da-da-da, he's going to destroy the world, right?
Mm-hmm.
In the comic books, the reason Onslaught was released was Xavier lost control.
But it was also, he sucked Magneto's brain into his own.
He sucked his not all of Magneto, like the evil part of Magneto.
Well, the evil part of Magneto, like, he basically left Magneto as a vegetable.
And then the evil part of Xavier kind of got together, overpowered him, boom. He lost control, which released Onslaught.
Yep.
The thing is, we never saw, and Onslaught would. Onslaught, the way the X-Men were set up in the movies, because they're not, up until recently, they weren't like this super-powered team. Like, watch X-Men 1, X-Men 2, X-Men 3.
Yeah.
You know, they are, they have superpowers, but they're not fucking Spider-Man getting the shit kicked out of them and doing that. They get punched, and it hurts in these movies.
Yeah.
Like, they did a very good job of saying, hey, even superhero fighting hurts. Onslaught's released, he would definitely have killed the X-Men.
Easily.
And Xavier would feel remorse for that because he would think it was his fault. Also, the psychic trauma of having that expunged from you,
you think would give him seizures?
Yeah, that could be a side effect of what had happened. The seizures and then the dementia kicking in, the also, like, cause imagine that is for years you've kept this powerful force
now
in
I,
your head.
I also, what I said when you were bringing this up on the phone was he's also like 100 years old.
90.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, he's old. No doubt about it, he's old. But still, as you get older, your brain deteriorates, all that. It's interesting to note, though, that his powers did not deteriorate. Xavier's powers, which should still succumb to age a little bit, did not deteriorate. The control did, but the powers did not.
I don't think that the power would ever deteriorate with a telepath. I would think that it would be completely... your mind would deteriorate, you would lose control, and you would have these episodes like he was having to where you could potentially nuke an area.
Yeah, nah, my thought is still this.
You think it was Onslaught?
It makes sense. It's like it's a fun fan theory.
That
Onslaught killed the X-Men.
I would like to see an article about that on the website.
I would like to see, you know, Kevin Feige dispute me on this.
No, I want you to write an article about it.
I'm gonna text Kevin Feige right now. I have his number in my phone.
Yeah.
Kevin Feige, what's up with Onslaught? Now what's gonna suck is, like, after the Dark Phoenix saga, they're gonna do an Onslaught movie and just wreck this theory.
Oh, it would be so cool if they did an Onslaught series.
Even though, what universe does Logan even take place in?
It's they said that that was like a side universe.
Right, so it's still possible.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And with the new Wolverine and all that, oh, man, Tom Hardy and their Venom, they're talking about it being the Lethal Protector series.
Yeah, I threw that. I was the one that threw that up on.
That's exciting, though.
Yeah, that whole, did you see the whole, there was like a 5-minute presentation.
Yeah, I watched it.
I put the clip up because the clip's what was important. No one really cared about the director going, we're going to make Venom awesome. And we're going to do this. No one cared about that. They were like, what's the story?
Well, you know what's funny is with Venom 2, it's also a, like, depending on who has, like, when Flash Thompson is Venom, when he loses control, Venom's a bad guy again.
Yeah.
And he'll fucking, Venom will go seek out Spider-Man because the symbiote still holds a grudge.
Yes.
And I think it would be so fun if they managed to incorporate that, because we're going to get the Lethal Protector.
Yeah, thing. Okay, here we go. Me being Negative Nancy. I still want a proper Venom villain movie.
Oh yeah,
and I feel like we're jumping ahead.
In a severe, disgusting way, we are jumping ahead.
Like, I want a good Venom movie, like Tom, like this Spider-Man, Tom Holland, this Venom. Oh my gosh, the fight of the Toms.
Yep.
Tom Hardy, like that would be awesome.
And based off what I've read, because initially they were like Venom's going to be in his own universe. It's actually in the MCU a little bit.
It is.
Which is fucking sick.
Well, because they wanted to do a horror movie.
We need it. It needs to be done.
Well, now we need a horror Avengers movie. Because we're getting a horror X-Men movie. We're getting a scary X-Men movie. We're going to get a scary Spider-Man movie.
We need a fucking evil Carnage. I want Cassidy to be going out.
Who would you choose to play Carnage?
Jerome. The kid that plays the Joker in the Gotham series, would be an excellent Cletus Cassidy.
I have two. Three suggestions. Mm-hmm. Bill Skarsgård, the guy that played It, that played Pennywise.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah, he could be good.
The redhead from Shameless.
That's the guy that I'm talking about. He plays the Joker in Gotham.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And Warshak from Watchmen.
Ooh, he would be good too. You know the issue, because
he's got that look. Like in the comics, he's got that look.
He does. He would. My issue with him, he's a decent actor.
He's a really good actor.
He murdered Freddy Krueger though. That movie was abysmal. That's directing and stuff like that.
Yeah, yeah. I don't blame him. Like his performance of Freddy Krueger was okay.
It was okay. It wasn't great.
But the movie was bad.
The movie was bad.
The movie was bad.
But that's when you're in a bad movie. You want to be that fucking shining star there to
and
at least
wasn't.
Be somewhat salvageable. You get what I'm
Nancy,
saying there.
Nancy was a shining star in that movie because she had a career.
Yeah. His is gone.
But his portrayal as Watchmen, Warshak was good.
Well, it was very good. But that also, here, let's get this out there. Watchmen was big in our community, but on the world stage, not many people knew who Watchmen were. So he was basically starting with the fucking clean slate.
Do you think Watchmen came out a little ahead of its time?
The movie?
Yeah.
Yes.
You think if they try to do it now?
I think if the movie would have waited 4 years.
So now?
No.
About
it was
5 years ago.
2007.
Yeah.
So the movie's over 10. So if they would have waited like 4 years and done it, right after all the Iron Man shit happened, fuck yeah, dude. And that would have been the one that could have put Warner Brothers on the map.
Instead of
the turds that
they
turned out.
You know, apparently it's not that big of a turd. Will Smith did sign up to do Suicide Squad 2.
Yeah, everybody signed up to do it. Dude, if they fucking are throwing money at me, I'm signing up for as many movies as they
That's
want.
That's not true, though. Will Smith has turned down roles over money. He has not turned down roles over money. I'm saying he has turned down roles when they've offered him an ungodly amount of money.
He also, he struggled with the whole playing a villain concept, which I think is hysterical. And David Ayer had to make him read, we've talked about this before, but David Ayer, the director, made him read a book about, it's basically, it talks about mindset and how nobody believes they're the bad guy.
Right.
And Will Smith was like, oh, cool, I can play this character now, which is fucking hysterical, because it's like, dude, you're making believe. You get paid to make believe, like,
right,
you shouldn't really struggle with playing
it. But he turned down Independence Day, too.
That's because it didn't need to happen.
I mean, I'm not saying it did, we don't need another Suicide Squad.
We could get a decent one. Like a decent flick, I'd be all about.
We don't need another one.
Because the first one, I enjoyed. I enjoyed Suicide Squad.
We got them together. We saw a fun little movie.
It was fun. And like I said,
I don't need another one.
The movie played out like a comic book. So I was cool with it. Take those characters and do stuff with them. Remove Killer Croc entirely because he was trash.
Or make him better in the next one.
Do a real actor, maybe. I don't know.
Whatever. Get Sylvester Stallone to play Killer Croc.
I would watch it. I would fucking watch it, dude.
Yeah. Because it's an older... I'm in. Like, I threw it off as a joke, but
you got this fucking... He's a jacked guy.
He is?
And he's 60-something years old, yeah, which is insane. But yeah, and he could be good.
He looked good in Guardians, too.
Yes, he did.
He looked real good in Guardians, too.
He was fucking cool in Guardians,
he
too.
He was. For, like 2 minutes he was on screen.
Does not matter.
Admit it, though. Admit it. Yondu's funeral. You
it got
little,
me.
A little.
No, you know what's funny is yesterday, Mary Poppins got brought up. So I had to search on YouTube for the scene where...
I'm like Mary Poppins.
I'm Mary Poppins, y'all. So good. Is he cool?
Yeah.
Hell yeah, he's cool. Yeah. That's what he said.
Hell yeah, he's cool.
So awesome.
I'm curious, though, to see how the Guardians are going to play into Infinity War.
Yeah. I mean, we have the stage very much set for it.
Oh, yeah. No, they all want Thanos dead.
And then Thor being like, who the hell are you guys?
We're the Guardians of the Galaxy. Who the fuck are you?
Yeah.
I'm Thor.
Bitch.
Yeah. And then I just picture Roger Coon stealing his hammer.
He can't.
Just because he would find a way.
He's not worthy.
He would find a way.
Completely unworthy.
He would find a way.
What I want to happen is while they're fighting Thanos, I want fucking Cap to pick it up.
To pick it up?
And just wreck shit.
Oh, man. You know, it would be so awesome if they incorporated just a little bit of fear itself.
That's what I'm saying.
Into Infinity War. And
that's
like,
what I'm saying.
Like, during, like, right before the fight or something, like, Sammy J walks up and says something to Thor, and you just see him drop the hammer.
Like, my fear itself was pretty bad.
Yeah.
It had some... There are redeeming panels in it.
And that's one of them.
Captain America picking up the hammer and fucking
wrecking. Well, he moved it.
He budged it.
But
if he's going to fight Thanos, worthy.
Oh,
worthy.
And I'm going to bring this up because it needs to be said. Hey, Jason O'Toole, they've brought a writer on to pen Black Widow the movie. You know, so there are in the exploratory stages of trying to make this Black Widow movie, Mister. It's not going
to
happen.
They have to. After Wonder Woman, they have
well,
to.
Well, no. Remember, no. I'm calling Jason out because during our meeting, Jason said there was one guy on the internet that said da 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 da. So everyone's running with it. They hired a fucking writer. They're looking into making a Black Widow movie, which is awesome. I just want to know why she doesn't have red hair.
Yeah.
That's all I want to know.
Because she looks hot as a platinum blonde.
She looks hotter as a redhead.
You're just into redheads.
I am, but she's hotter as a redhead.
She looks beautiful as a redhead.
I saw her. We watched that movie. I don't know what it was called, but it was her and her bachelorette party.
Okay.
And they killed a stripper.
Okay.
But she was a blonde in that. And I was watching. I'm like, yeah, she's good looking, but she's still better as Black Widow.
No, she doesn't. As a blonde, she doesn't really do it for me. But it, with the darker hair, a platinum blonde, I'm sold. I love platinum blonde. I mean, I have one.
But also, you know, Black Widow has red hair.
She does.
You know.
She does.
I can get over Captain America growing a beard. That makes sense to me.
A nice beard, too.
It's a good beard. It's a good rockin' hipster beard. He looks good in it. But I don't get why her hair went from red to blonde. I hope I get an explanation.
It looks gray, almost.
Maybe she got scared.
Maybe
it was like Ash in Evil Dead 2 when the thing showed up and his hair turned white.
Maybe she's just... in hiding and trying to look a little different.
What's she hiding from?
I don't know.
Because
She was on the right side, but she also sabotaged some stuff.
Well, yeah, she didn't want anyone to die.
She sabotaged some stuff, which would make her a criminal.
She didn't want anyone to die.
And if that word got out to Mr. Stark, who's all butthurt and pissy, he'd be like, you're a criminal too!
Because that's not his shield. You don't deserve that shield.
Criminal!
Until, you know, Infinity War shows up and fucking... Black Panther's like, give him his shield.
Well, he's like, make this man a shield.
Give him his shield.
I'm so stoked for that.
What, Black Panther?
Yes.
I'm not. Like, I'm not saying that because, one, Black Panther is a character that I actually really would like to see on film. But I think it would work better as...
A series?
A Netflix show. Yeah. Yes.
Have you seen that they're kicking around Daredevil and the Netflix characters being in Infinity War more and more?
No.
Yeah, I keep seeing little things here and there, and little hints are getting dropped. Like, oh, it can happen.
I hope not.
It would be fucking cool, dude.
Though
it would be fucking.
Though to
cool.
be fair, I don't see how they could not.
Daredevil and Spider-Man together, I need that shit.
Yeah, I would love. Problem is, what you'll get is like a 2-minute conversation on a movie screen where you'd have an entire. Imagine an entire episode of season 3 Daredevil of Daredevil sitting up having coffee with Spider-Man on the rooftop, talking about just everything. How awesome would that be? That'd be way cooler than the 2 minutes of "Hey, Hornhead. Oh, hi, Spidey."
I want the
and
I
credit for getting that code, that nickname right for Daredevil. What?
I want the fucking synergy that they have fighting. I want them fighting side by side.
Yeah.
And then Wolverine and Captain America fighting side by side.
I hope they do not put Wolverine
or fucking
in
Wolverine
anymore.
And the Punisher.
How would all? So here's how they can introduce the mutants in the MCU.
Infinity War causes something to happen.
Exactly. Yep. Like wakens the mutant gene.
Well, because you kind of saw that with the Inhuman concept.
I didn't watch Inhumans.
No. In Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., the Inhumans are starting to pop up. It's like, that was basically their version of
the
mutants.
Mutants, yeah.
And now it's like, well, you got the fucking mutants, so.
You can say the M word now.
They do.
You can say mutant.
Oh, they do.
Mutant.
Don't you worry.
The ink isn't even dry yet, and you can say mutant now.
It's French.
It's French for the Inhuman.
Mutant.
It's French for Inhuman.
The mutant.
Mutant. I did like that Logan though. The explanation on why the mutants went away. Did you
go on?
Do you not remember this?
Off the top of my head. No.
The whole genetically modifying corn syrup and vegetables and fruits to stop the mutant gene from activating outside a controlled environment.
Okay.
So that was the big thing. That's why no mutants were there. Is it wasn't, you know, you hear Logan say, well, maybe we weren't part of God's plan. And then you get this like paragraph of dialogue, which basically says it's because of genetically engineering food, they have stopped the mutants from being a thing.
Yeah, they weeded them out.
Right. Other than controlled circumstances.
Yeah.
Which is cool to me.
That is cool.
The other thing
that's a fucking huge conspiracy.
It is.
Huge.
It is. And I kind of wish now that, you know, Marvel, Fox, X-Files. Let's do an X-Files TV show about stopping mutants.
Have you seen fans are petitioning to have that guy from The Office that initially was going to be Cap? What's his name?
Jim from The Office.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Him playing Mr. Fantastic.
I would.
First of all, I was like, okay, that's interesting. Then I see an image of him as Mr. Fantastic, and I was like, fucking done, do it.
Him,
do it.
Him or that guy from The Conjuring? And
okay.
Insidious?
Yeah.
Like, Patrick...
Who would you have as a Human Torch?
Doesn't matter, they're going to be covered in flame all the time.
Getting a good personality for him is right.
I'm going to say this, he'd have to lose a lot of weight, but I think his personality would be awesome. Seth Rogen or James Franco?
Franco? Now, he's going to be playing a villain in the MCU.
All right, well, then he's out. Okay. He's too old. It's not like we can't CGI and DH people nowadays. That's what
need
we do.
To. Get a younger. They did the right thing by getting a younger actor to play Spidey.
They did.
So I think having somebody a little bit older than Spidey, a couple years older, would be a good thing.
Okay, then who are you thinking about?
You don't have to cast a known actor. That's the thing. I'm cool with it being a no name. That's why I was asking who you think it should be.
I want someone that's funny that always makes me laugh. Because to me, Johnny Storm is the. He's the wisecracking.
Okay.
You know, him. Like, to me, the trifecta of bros in the Marvel MCU is Spider-Man.
Yep.
Human Torch and Iceman. Like, those three together, they are the fraternity. They're beer-bonging it up in the MCU.
What if they did Spider-Man and His Amazing Friends as a Netflix
I'm
series?
Out. I'm
that
out.
Would be fucking
I'm
hysterical.
Because who the fuck? It was
Iceman
and Dazzler.
Firestar,
that's it.
And
yeah.
Spidey.
Yeah, I'm out.
That
I'm
would
out
be so
I'm
funny.
Out. No.
But what if they... Okay, so they take it and they do it with Johnny Storm and Iceman instead
of
Firestar.
I'm in. I'm back in.
You would have all your wise
I'm
cracks.
Back in. Them going off to college.
It
was like Animal House.
It was fucking hilarious, dude.
You know, and Spider-Man gets turned down for the fraternity he really wants to get into. Lambda, Gamda, Gamda. So they have to start their own fraternity. It's called the MCU. I don't fucking know. I'm in.
Unicorn.
Hey, Netflix. Or fuck it, Disney. You own everything now. You're going to buy us. Here's our idea. Here's what we bring to the table. A Spider-Man college TV show.
That'd be pretty funny. Tom Holland would eat that shit
He
up.
Would do it in a heartbeat.
You know what's funny is they won't tell him things that are happening in the movie because
he's been
bad about spoiling
he's
things.
He's like, oh, by the way, guess what? Iron Man will die. I wasn't supposed to say that. My bad. Oops. I thought everyone knew.
I think it's hysterical. All right, so
I get
we're going to give you a script, and they hand him a script, and it's got like four lines on it, and the line before his and the line after his, just so he knows when he's supposed to say what he's supposed to say. We're going to CG you in here. I just want you to read these lines.
Oh, that's funny. That's funny. So we're going to talk about Star Wars for a second.
Yeah.
I watched a YouTube video. I'm going to post it up.
Uh-huh.
It is talking about, you know, our biggest complaint about episode 7.
Yeah.
Yeah, it talks about how episode 8 is just a redo of Empire.
It's not.
And it goes into detail, and I'm like...
It's not.
Hmm.
Where I think that's a cute idea, it's not.
It's a redo.
No, it isn't.
It's a redo.
It's not. It's a redo. Have you seen it?
No.
No?
My brother will be in town next weekend.
No, I was going to say, shut your mouth, because you've not seen it.
So?
It's not Empire.
And during that video, they also gave a good reasoning on why Luke didn't know about Han being dead.
Because he was on a fucking rock. In
bullshit.
The middle of
nowhere. He was on Dagobah and he still knew Han and Leia were in danger. He's one with the Force.
Go on. What are you saying?
So the theory is...
You don't know what you're talking about because you've not seen the movie.
Would you shut the fuck up and let me tell you this?
Yeah.
All right. God damn. Simmer down. Don't no need to yell. Because Luke turned away from the Jedi and turned away from all that, he had to close himself off to the Force.
He did that.
Which is why he didn't know that Han died.
Correct.
Yeah. There you go. Done.
That's what they did.
Yeah. I'm just letting you know, that's boom, done. Everyone was bitching about how come Luke didn't know Han died. Well, here you go.
He had closed himself off to the Force, and they made that blatantly apparent, and then when he opens himself back up to it, it's fucking magical.
Aw, does he...
You don't want to know.
Does he splooge a little?
To
be fair, Capuano kind of was like, hey, guess what? Here's the deal about Snoke. And I was like, I don't care.
The Snoke thing was... It was a little disappointing.
Like, he's a MacGuffin. Okay, whatever. He still is a fucking... He is still the leader of the fucking... Thing.
Of the big bads.
Right. So I don't care what his thing is.
Not anymore.
Well, I mean, whatever. But you get what I'm saying. It's not that it's not the end of the world. Guess what? People die, things move on. Sometimes you rise from nothing. You don't have to be ingrained. You don't have to be a Skywalker to do good or evil in this fucking universe, people.
I'm thinking back on the movie now and I'm getting excited about things because I'm like stewing over here, and I want to just fucking blurt a bunch of stuff out, but I'm not going to. There's a lot of stuff that they did right in the new movie. There's things that needed to be fixed, of course, but there's a lot that they did right.
Until they retcon everything in the third movie.
That'd be hilarious.
This movie just doesn't happen. Princess Leia, help
us. The expanded universe is now back in effect.
Oh my god. Oh god, that would suck.
That would be awesome.
That would suck. Like, all of a sudden, Han's back alive, Chewie's dead, there's like three Solo kids, it's a whole thing.
Correct, yeah.
Yeah.
That would be awesome.
Yeah, Luke's gone evil, back to good, evil again.
Some big Force event happens and causes all of that to be back in existence.
I would love to see, like, Heir to the Empire, the original book trilogy.
Done
in, like, either anime form or TV form or something.
There are a bunch of extended... I would love the Plagueis the Wise movie. Reaven stuff. I'm all about the Reaven. You don't have to like it. He's a badass. Badass.
Here's the thing. When you and Joe talk about the extended universe, you guys talk about the past. Like, you talk about the stuff that happened before.
Yeah.
When I talk about the extended universe, I'm like, fuck! Chewie died. You know how Chewie fucking died?
The future.
He got smooshed by a planet.
Han and Leia have all these kids, and there's a new Jedi temple.
Or how about when the Hutts stole the Death Star plans and are trying to build a new Death Star because that's gangsta shit?
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's the extended universe I talk about. I don't give a shit about that past shit.
The past stuff is fun.
The past stuff is fun, but you know what? The whole point to me of the extended universe was to carry on the story between Luke, Leia, and Han, right?
The Plagueis story tells you how all of the Star Wars movies came to be there. It's fucking awesome.
No, because
Bith putting everything in motion for hundreds of years.
Whatever. I had a new hope. I don't need.
Well, no, that's what made a new hope.
I don't need. I don't need to
and
know what happened
before.
You got a new
hope twice.
Yeah. Yes, I did. Yes. Yes, I did. So, I don't need that, though. Like, to me, the extended universe was about carrying on the storylines of these characters and seeing where they went. That's why when we all talk Star Wars and Joe starts talking about the past, I'm like, I don't give a fuck. Let's talk about how... How the solo kids are all fucked up and the middle one's spoiled as shit.
The past is doomed to repeat itself? You've never heard that, huh?
You know, it didn't happen in the book, so we're good. I mean, it did happen. Luke went good or bad like 5 or 6 different times.
Because Reed.
And then there was the new Jedi Order, or the new Order, whatever, where the fucking aliens from the other universe invaded. That shit was good. X-Wing was good.
X-Wing!
Like, that was a good storyline.
Is it a miniatures game?
It is, but no, there was a book. You never read the books?
No, I didn't read that book.
It's a series of books.
How many is it?
7?
Oh, wow.
7 books? And it's all about Rogue Squadron doing shit.
Nice.
It's all about, what's his name? Not Porkins. Wedge.
Mm-hmm.
It's all about Wedge and what Wedge... And Wedge is a badass. And Rogue Squadron did more than fly X-Wings. They were like the rebel fucking special forces. They were the Marines.
They were the rebel Navy SEALs.
Yeah, they were. Like the first book's about them going behind enemy lines to rescue a TIE pilot who's trying to
switch sides.
Yeah, what's that? It's switch sides. But what's the actual fucking political term for it? Deter, defer, to fucking.
He's a flippy floppy.
He's a flippy floppy. He's a politician. So basically, But yeah, they have to go behind enemy lines and sneak into a camp and like it's fucking amazing.
Sounds good.
It's a good book.
Sounds good. We went to Barnes and Noble this past week. And
are they still around?
Yeah. We wanted to go to a bookstore, pick up a couple of books, and we're there. Tara's reading through this Disney series, and they're actually
aren't they all Disney series at this point?
Basically, okay. But it's about like Maleficent, Ursula, the Queen from Snow White,
all the bad bitches.
The Beast has one. Yeah, it's about the bad guys. And she's reading through these. She powered through the Queen one, then she went and got the Ursula one, and I think she wants to do Maleficent next, and then the Beast. And they're cool, but they're hard. We got these hardcover books, and the hardcover's the villain, how you know how they look.
Right.
And then the slip, you pull the slip off, and you see the villain's other form. So, like, all of them did some transformation or some disguise.
Right.
And
that's
it's very beautiful touch. But we're at the bookstore, and bookstores are doing something brilliant that they've been doing this for the last few years.
Just try to stay in business.
Not just that, but they're putting out books like leather bound and hardcover books that all look like they go in a set, but it's a story fairy tale classics and all that.
That's how my complete works of Shakespeare and H.G. Wells and all that.
They're beautiful. And if you want to put them in like a personal library, that's what you want there. You know what I mean? And I picked up an Art of War, Sun Tzu's Art of War, leather bound. It's beautiful.
It was like $10.
$7.99. Yeah. Little red book. Yeah. Oh my God, it is sick. Yeah. But I love them. So then I went to V-Stock yesterday, and they have some of those there too. And it's classic Grimm fairy tales, the Sherlock Holmes. Oh my God.
What time does V-Stock close?
What's today? Sunday?
Yeah.
They close at like 5 or 6.
I need to go. Okay.
Chesterfield Mall's a ghost town.
Is it?
So, 6 months ago, bunch of stores there. Now, almost all of them are gone.
V-Stock's still there?
Yep.
Okay. That's
all that matters.
That's all that matters at this point.
Or you can go to Mid Rivers.
Which one's closer?
Mid Rivers is probably a little faster for you.
Is it? Okay.
Yeah, it'd be a little faster for you.
That's close.
It's close, but I think it takes about 20 minutes to get to Chesterfield.
Maybe that's what we'll do, is I'll go to Mid Rivers Mall, get dinner tonight. Sounds like a plan.
Get some Charlie's.
Hey, Courtney! So...
What do you want to pick up at V-Stock?
I
want to
look at some Super Nintendo games.
Fair point.
I picked up... So, I'm on the hunt for the classic, right?
Yeah.
Like, I don't want to pay more than $80 for it, because once you get above, like, 120... You really got that cost effect.
You're talking about the SNES?
Yes, the SNES Classic.
Call Walmart down by me.
Okay.
They had them. And
that's a far drive, though.
If you want me to go pick one up for you, though, and the next time I come up here...
We'll talk.
Okay.
But I'm on the hunt for one, because if you get above 120, then you got to start looking at the games and stuff like that. Because right now, like I told you, it is cheaper to buy that than to try to find the games in cartridge form. Okay.
You know what you need to look at?
Don't you dare tell me that fucking Pi system.
The Sega Genesis one. So they basically did the same thing.
Except it's not licensed by Sega.
It's got like 80 games on it. I don't fucking care. This is Sega branded. There's an Atari one as well.
No, fucking do your research on this. It's the same stuff that comes out year after year. It's a cheap knockoff thing made in Brazil. They have the Sega stuff on it, but the games run like crap. The sound isn't right. There's a little bit of lag.
I'm gonna look into this now, yeah. Because this it has Sega's logo on
it. It does. No, it does, but it's not a good system.
Huh.
Now, speaking of that, though, RetroCon, the guys that made like a bunch of shit, like keeping games alive,
yeah,
have partnered with Sega to make new Genesis, Saturn, Dreamcast paraphernalia and such. So we could be getting new Sega games, new Sega shit.
Interesting, okay.
For our stuff. And which means they're going to release the systems and the whole thing. So we might get something in the future done quality. But right now, that shit you see for $50
mm-hmm.
is a pile of shit. Now, it might work well for the Atari since it's, you know, 4 bits instead of 16 bits, basically.
Yeah.
You know, it might work well for the Atari, but the sound and the game, it lags. The frame rate's not right.
Really?
It's a really shitty ROM. It's a really shitty emulation of the Sega games.
But you also can play the actual games on it.
You can, and that's okay. But
and
the
Sega games are dirt cheap.
Sega games are dirt cheap, but the sound chip isn't the same, and the sound sounds muffled and distorted.
Really?
Yeah.
That's interesting.
I did my research on those, because I love Sega. I love Sega more
than
Super
Nintendo.
I know
you do. That's why I said the Sega thing.
And I was going to get one. I was like, it's cheaper. It's got all the Sonic games. It's got Mortal Kombat, blah, blah, blah. I was doing my research, and everyone just kind of lambasted it. They're like, the best
really?
Thing to do is just fucking go get a Sega and buy the carts.
That's crazy.
Yeah. So the X-Files.
Yep.
Two episodes in now.
Yeah.
First episode. I'm going to fuck on spoiling it, guys, for you out there. If you haven't watched the X-Files yet, turn it down.
Tune out.
I'll give you a second. Chris is getting up to get something. While he gets that, we'll wait.
Just keep.
No,
good.
No.
Good.
We're waiting for them to turn down. All right, here we go.
Turn down for what?
Turn down for what? Do you think? All right, so it came out that the cigarette smoking man is the father of Scully and Mulder's kid.
Yep.
And everyone on the internet went all hoogity foogity saying that, well, he raped her.
Okay.
I don't think it's rape. Hear me out.
Yeah.
I don't think he's the biological father of Mulder and Scully's son.
No?
I think what he did, because there was an episode where they drove somewhere and it was supposed to be the cure for everything. I think what he did when she passed out was since he made it to where she couldn't get pregnant.
Okay.
Like, she was abducted, they took all the eggs, gave her cancer, did all that stuff. I think he just reversed it.
All right.
Fixed it to where she could get pregnant under certain circumstances. Her and Mulder.
Pound it out.
Like they were supposed to do. Boom. Here comes a kid.
Okay.
Done. Not rape. He just made it to where she could get pregnant. That's just my thoughts. It's not like he impregnated her.
Okay.
He just fixed what was wrong with her. Something that...
You're healed.
Well, yeah, and up until that point, it was 7 seasons on, and from season 4 to 7, those 3 years, a big problem with Scully was she wanted to be a mother but couldn't. And it was a big thing on the character.
Yeah.
She couldn't get pregnant. And now, season 7, at the end, she's like, I don't know how... Or season 8 at the end, she's like, I don't know how, but I'm pregnant. Well, if he fixed her, and the timeline there, everyone's all like, oh, the timeline doesn't make sense, people. If he knocked her up in season 7, and she doesn't have the kid till season 9, or 8, that's like a year and a half, 2 years go by.
Yeah.
You guys, that just doesn't make sense. Use your fucking brain.
Right. Think about this, people.
But the second episode, and this is my big gripe. I loved the second episode. It was an amazing episode. But it was nothing but one action scene after another. Like, it was just constant action. They were on the run. And it was a great episode. It was a great TV. But that's not The X-Files. The X-Files is slow. It's methodical. It creeps into you. Even those funny, fast-paced action episodes were very thought-derivative. This one felt like I was watching Rambo.
Have you gone back and rewatched it yet?
Yeah. I mean, I love the episode, but it's not...
I didn't know if you'd gone back and rewatched it and maybe you got some of that thinking candy that you were looking for.
No, there's nothing. Like, there's a little bit there because it's that episode was all about. The episode starts, they're sitting there sleeping. Mulder's phone's ringing, it's Langley who died. Like, Langley's been dead, and it's him communicating. Russians show up, and then the whole thing goes on. But you find out that they're downloading people's consciousnesses into an artificial program. And when you die, your consciousness gets turned on there. So now you're living in this artificial world.
Okay, so we have to talk about this now.
Okay.
There was a huge science expo recently. I don't remember what it was called.
Yes, I know exactly where you're going.
And they reveal that you can download your consciousness and put it in a new body.
But
this brain thing. First of all, we don't know that it works.
We don't know that it doesn't.
We don't. The fact, if they are growing entire human bodies.
But these aren't, From what I saw, they weren't flesh and blood. They were silicone and
oh, they said they're working with human skin and stuff.
Now they are?
That was part of the announcement in there. So, and basically, I saw there's a picture of this fucking body stuffed in a bag.
Yeah, I saw that.
And it looks like they might be trying to grow people.
Well, I saw, and they showed the, like, what I thought was, like, where your consciousness would go into, which makes you kind of look like a robot. Because it's all fake, like Terminator shit.
Yeah.
My first thought was, okay, so your consciousness is put in here. What happens to your desires? Like the desire for sex.
They said that it's a fully functional body. Now, if you have this fake body, biological impulses should not be happening.
Right.
So I don't know. I don't buy into it. And here's the thing. Consciousness, we don't fully understand.
Right. But we do live in a world. I'd like to point this out. We live in a world where we have cloned animals.
Yeah, but it's not the same animal.
It's not the same animal. But we have we do live in the world where the fantastical is possible.
We do. And here. And but what we...
I
what
pick
we,
up your cell phone as a prime example.
What we understand about these things and what we're learning about biology and stuff, like, we've cloned animals.
Right.
Now, cloning, the idea that we had initially, is it's the same thing. And when you're cloning these animals, it's not actually the same animal.
No, but we're getting better and better.
Genetic makeup is very, very similar. So, you know, we're getting close, but it's very peculiar. It's odd. It's very odd. And with consciousness, because I actually...
We've had this conversation a year ago on this show about consciousness and what would happen if we transferred consciousness somewhere else.
And I don't believe that's something that is fully possible. I think it's a romanticized idea. I think there's part of being and part of existence that kind of stretches a little bit beyond what we beyond material and biological elements.
Okay, let's take hold on. Now, we can still use spirituality here, because if that's the path you're going, let's throw it out there. Let's pretend that we have evidence of a soul. Let's pretend that our consciousness and all that is...
Okay, so if you look at humans, there's something called collective consciousness. And
right.
We're going way off the rails here for the show, but
this is fucking geeky shit.
Yeah, this is cool. So with humans, there's something called collective consciousness, and there are things that are programmed into every human that we all know. Like, if you see certain symbols or stuff like that, it evokes a certain feeling in you. And there are, like, if you look at basically any picture of God or a deity, they all look very similar. There's a little more that plays into it than that. But there's elements of this picture of a God or a creator or whatever that evoke an emotional response in a human being, and it's not just because we've been trained, because there's people that you can show it to somebody early on in life before they've really had the opportunity to be exposed to too much of that, and it'll evoke the same emotional response, and this is because of a collective consciousness. And there's actually Carl Jung, who's basically the father of modern psychology, did a lot of work on this, and he was a student of Nietzsche, who is big in the psychology world, and he did a bunch of work on this, and he basically tried to put spirituality back into psychology because of things like collective consciousness and so on
but,
and so on.
Okay, so what I'm saying is, if we're going to we're all going to agree, listeners, we're all agreeing on this. This is just for a point.
It's a for instance.
Right. So there is a soul.
Okay.
If the downloading of the conscious, if the theory is that when you die, your soul
leaves
your body.
Yeah, are you transferring your soul?
You would be. No, maybe that's your consciousness. Your consciousness is your soul, and what is being transferred with your consciousness is your soul. So you would, so instead of taking that next step, which would be your soul escapes, and we don't know what happens, why the souls go where they go, or whatever. Mm-hmm. But we're saying we have a soul, and when you die, something happens. If they can redirect what is happening
with your soul
and put it there, you would still be you.
That would be scary in here.
I'm not saying it's not scary.
Well, like the thing that
but we would live forever.
The thing that that kind of raises my suspicion with things like this is there are biological elements that affect consciousness. There's something outside of biology that affects consciousness.
Only because the only way we have consciousness is through a biological element.
A biological process.
Because
correct.
We are humans. We are flesh. We are bone. We are cellular. We are
correct.
Tissue.
Correct. Now. And this is one of the things that I want to state, and this is one of the things that I guess that I'm trying to convey as it pertains to consciousness. With consciousness, it is not simply a set of memories. And I feel like with these robot people that they're wanting to make, they're like, hey, we can download your memories, but consciousness goes beyond experience.
Right. I think, therefore, I am. If you just download memories, you're not downloading the protocol.
Correct.
Thing.
And that's kind of what I'm going into here.
But here's the thing. You're looking right now at the beginning. You're looking at Bill Gates sitting in his fucking garage working on
but
Windows.
This isn't a new concept.
No, but it's not a new concept, but the practicality of actually trying to implement it is.
Yeah.
So you're looking at the beginning of implementation. And if this works, if you can actually download your memories, your physical memories, into another being, because that's what it would be at that point.
Yeah.
Manufactured or not, it's another being. And
a new vessel.
And you keep working and you keep doing that. It's just memories, experiences, emotion, thought, all start coming into one. And 15, 20, 30 years down the road, we could be looking at a world where you don't die. And it's interesting because there is a book called Old Man's War.
Yeah.
Where the theory is when you reach your 80s, you sign up for the military.
Okay.
What they do, they kill your body, put you into a new superior genetically modified body.
Okay.
You go fight your war. When your term of service is up, you go back and they put you into a body of you, the exact copy of your body at your mid-20s. Their theory is this. 19-year-olds don't know what they're fighting for. 80-year-olds, they've had kids, grandkids, loved ones die. They know what it's about. They know what life is about. So they should be the ones fighting. If this is the start, we are close. We are just a jump away. And to sit there and definitively say we can't do it, you're right. We can't do it now. But if we keep working on it, who's to say what the future
I'm not
holds?
Saying that it's impossible. What I'm saying is I believe there are elements outside of what we understand because we try to objectify things in a very serious way.
Right.
And I hate to break it to you, but we don't live in a completely objective world. We don't live in a completely material world.
But hold on. Understanding grows. And if this is just a stepping stone to learning that understanding...
This could also be a gross molestation of what it is to be human. They could be taking memories and shit like that, downloading them into this robot, or uploading them into this robot, and then there's some robot running around with my memories and stuff, but not my consciousness, and it's fucking, it's like, oh yeah, no, I'm Chris.
Yeah, no, hold on.
That's fucking scary.
It could go one or two ways. Either you live forever, or we're at the point of the singularity event, and Zach was right.
I mean, we could be there.
I mean, we could. Like, it's a very weird moment to be... We live in a very weird moment. And we take it for granted. I want you to think about this. I want you to think about the world we're living in. 2 weeks ago, the government came out and said, oh, yeah, we've been doing research on UFOs this whole time.
Mm-hmm.
We know for a fact there's UFOs. They've pretty much come out and said, we know aliens exist. And nobody has said a fucking word about it. You go back to the 90s, if that would have happened, shit. Yeah.
It's how information is dispersed, though. The government didn't... Here, hold on. It's not like President Trump did this big press conference where he was like, yes, aliens are real. Because then that would have caused an uproar. They declassified documents and stuff that said, hey, UFOs are a thing. Now, that doesn't... And here, I want you to take this and... You take it with a grain of salt, whatever, but it's not confirming or denying aliens or the existence of aliens. It's saying there are flying objects that we don't fully understand.
It's more than that.
Be it from another government or something like that.
But it's more than that. Okay. It is because releasing, declassifying these conversations, declassifying these documentations show one thing that the government, ever since Project Blue Book mm-hmm. was supposedly declassified and done, they've kept going.
Oh, yeah.
Okay? They're admitting that there's something that we don't understand, which... Even we live in a world like that is the government saying for the past 60 years, we've been lying to you and we let it go.
Yeah.
It's just a weird world we live in. Like we let that go. That goes away. This whole downloading consciousness, downloading memories into something should be like front page, should be something that everyone's talking about. We let it go. And here's what we as a society are talking about. We are talking about the iPhone 10.
I don't think it's... There's a lot of these things that aren't real to people. Okay? Let me explain.
Okay, I get it.
It's not there, so it's not real. Like, your phone is something that you... Fuck, everybody lives in these.
Yeah. Oh, my God. So that's... Real quick about the phone. That and the X-Files?
Yeah.
Like, that's how they were scanning people's brains to put them into that artificial world, right? Like, they're like, because everyone uses cell phones.
Fuck that.
And they would just get little bits of information on every phone call you make, and eventually they would have your whole consciousness scanned to put in this artificial world.
When that's when we could get into this whole what is consciousness thing, and that's
a circular argument.
That is something that we as humans don't fully understand
yet.
We might not ever.
We might not.
Because there are elements of everything that we deny because we are partial. And
but
that's something that we can't help.
As long as we keep making advances like this, as long as we keep moving forward.
I want no part of it. I want death at some point.
That's fine. You can have your death.
Oh, I will.
You don't have to go over. It's not like someone's forcing you to download your consciousness.
How pissed would you be, though? Hold on. How pissed would you be if your fucking kids... Because I've got those. If your fucking kids are like, no, dad was cool. Let's fucking upload him. We'll upload him into this new body. He's going to be great. And they're fucking playing with dad bot outside. And this fucking cocksucker's running around with my memories. Kids, we are having so much fun. Look at how good we're... Remember that time we played ball in the front yard 10 years ago? And they're like, yeah, dad, that was fucking awesome. No.
Here's the scary thing. So you're not telling the robot your memories, right? You're not sitting there going...
Exactly. I'm not confiding in
you. No. Hold on. You're not... Like, when they download your memories, it's not like you're sitting there with an auto recording going, and on March 1st at 3:30 p.m., because you don't fucking remember, right? You don't remember exactly...
Parts of your brain do. The human brain is incredible.
No. That's the thing. They're downloading that. They're downloading the memories that you don't truly remember you remember. How the fuck are they doing it? That's what's fucking me up. How are they downloading
memories that you're not telling them? We don't fully understand what they're getting, and yeah, there's an aspect of humanity where privacy is golden. Like my kids,
we gave that away a long
time
ago.
My kids don't need to know about every shit that I ever took, and I think somewhere deep inside of my brain it's probably stored up. Hey, shit in this time, and then the fucking robo me comes out, robo dad, and he's like, remember that time I shit? And the kids are like, what the fuck are you talking about, robo dad? On this date at this time I took a shit.
But I sat on the toilet extra long. No, because that would be too much. Like, that'd be too much. Like, it's not you. The whole idea of this is that it's you. So you would still have that. It would still be that sort of you, because you wouldn't talk about it. Robo Dad wouldn't talk about it.
Well, and that's this whole consciousness argument that we're going to get into here, or that we keep getting into, because consciousness is not. It can't be computed.
Right. At this moment.
Well, okay. I with everything that goes into it, I don't believe that it is something that can be computed.
At this moment.
Now, Walt Disney may have had the right idea. Cut my head off, fucking freeze it, stick it on a new body later.
Maybe
this cryogenics thing is a more
we've kind of given up on cryogenics in the mainstream.
Hold on. It's not been given up on. And then when you're talking about people getting head transplants and shit, if we can flash freeze somebody's brain, stick it on a new body, that's when I think you would get into this whole, all right, we did a full brain transplant, we got this fucking donor body, because we can basically grow a body. We know how to grow body parts and stuff like that. So if you grew a body, and at this point, you could clone tissues of an individual and maybe get them into a 20-year-old body.
Right.
The robot thing, I don't think it can be done through computers.
What if it's a combination of the both?
I don't
cybernetics
know.
And
that would
and
be
I think
fucking
that,
real.
That would be the way to go.
It'd be scary.
It would be scary.
I'm scared of it nonetheless.
And then we have the Borg.
Yeah,
because then you are the because you could download your memories and your stuff into safekeeping, do the head transplant, re-upload everything with a port and the thing, and now we're living in fucking Shadowrun. Oh my god.
Yeah. Vision summed it up best in Age of Ultron, and he said the beautiful thing about life is that it ends. Basically, I'm paraphrasing.
Right, but
it needs to end, people.
But hold on, because now, but just because. Your consciousness is being trans. You've still died. It's the Star Trek argument. Every time they go into the transporter, because physically speaking, you can either know one or two things. You can either know what every atom is or where every atom is at. There's a whole thing. So every time they step in the transporter and they beam up, they kill themselves. What's stepping out of the transporter beam is a different person.
Huh.
Yeah. Chief O'Brien is the most, has killed more people than Hitler, Stalin, combined. Okay, so, but the argument is, you would still die. It's not like you're going to sit there and you won't know.
But when they're talking about being on the verge of immortality and immortality being viable, that's not you dying at that point. And that's the part that everybody's...
No, you would still die. Like
your physical body.
But here, even if they upload your consciousness, it's not like they're... they're not transferring consciousness. They're copying and allowing that consciousness to go on.
Well, and that's the thing. We don't fully understand consciousness, so what they're doing is fucking abysmal. It's like the whole Jurassic Park thing. It's not can we do it, should we do it? Fuck no.
It's like this. Okay, so you're here.
Mm-hmm.
Little Robo Chris. Yeah. All right, I'm Little Robo Chris. They download my shit, upload it into you. Into me. You're still there. I go this way, you go that way. You die. I'm still out there, but I'm not you.
Correct.
But and, I am.
But consciousness, see, consciousness is what we are, though.
So yeah, I don't know. Guys, here's the thing. We're going to put a little Facebook post about this. I'm going to do it tonight. And we're going to link the article.
Fucking weird.
Read the article. Tell us what you think. Like, I want to continue this conversation. I want to hear what you crazy fuckers think out there about the whole consciousness, immortality, robot, clones, head thing. How do we extend our lives? Basically,
eating healthy and accepting our inevitable demise.
But we don't. We as human beings, we as individuals, do not accept our inevitable demise. We keep pushing and pushing and pushing and pushing and pushing to extend our lives.
There are things that we can do to live a long, healthy life.
I mean, we're no longer dying in our 50s and 60s in the masses. Like, you can still die in your 60s, but that's still considered...
Okay, but one of the things that I do want to point out here, if you look at our founding fathers, Benjamin Franklin didn't die till he was 84. George Washington died in his 80s. Like, these people were only supposed to live to be about 50. I think that is complete bullshit.
Not 50. When this
50, 60 years old.
60?
It was actually 50 was life expectancy.
In Europe, when you were cramped in castles eating shit for a living.
See, it wasn't that. No. 40 years old was medieval times. You might live to be 40.
You know, the average, like, yes, you can point to history. There's people that lived over 120 years old in history. But you look at the average life expectancy, and that was the 60. That was 60.
And we've
raised it to 70 now.
We're actually closer to 80 now.
You know, so we've already figured out how to...
That's quality of life. That's war. There's a lot of things that play into that. There are diseases that we've alleviated.
Right. But the next big outbreak could happen tomorrow, and guess what? Your life expectancy is going to drop.
Average life expectancy would drop.
Like, hardcore, because who's going to die first? All the old people.
Well, then you have to look at things like genocide, because that would play into average life expectancy.
I don't know.
It would.
Yeah. Well, and no, it would. Like
if you look at... Okay.
The average life expectancy in a third world country is 55 years old. Mm-hmm. Because of poverty, genocide, war, malnutrition, mm-hmm. education, disease, exposure, the whole thing.
Mm-hmm.
But that's because they're born there, and that's the life that they have.
An average life expectancy of an American male... And that's an average, okay? So the average American male is going to live to be like 76. And that's now.
And females live to 84. And do you know why that is?
No.
Because we want to get away quicker.
Our hearts actually beat faster, and your heart does have how many beats it can
do you know why?
Produce in a lifetime.
Do you know why our hearts beat
Stress.
Faster? Because we deal with the women folk.
All right, guys. If you have not already, go to entertainthegeeky.com. You can follow us on all of our social media there. Get in on this consciousness conversation. And guys, as always, stay geeky.
I think you'll live forever.